Hello everyone, welcome back. The topic for today is apexification. Now what do you mean by apexification? So fication is nothing but to make or to create. So in this, what are you making? So you're making the apex. Now why do you need to make an apex? So over here there are two scenarios. In this there is closed apex and over here there is open apex. So now what do you mean by closed and open apex? Now we know that eruption sequence. So now for example, if your incisor is erupting at the age of 7 to 8 years, but now in this you'll see that the tooth has erupted in the oral cavity, but the root is not yet formed. So it takes like around 2 to 3 years more for the formation of the complete root. Now though the tooth has erupted, that means the crown has erupted in the oral cavity. So for example, if there's any problem, like if there is caries which has involved that particular tooth in which the root is not yet formed, or if there is trauma to this particular tooth. So what happens is now you have to go for your root canal treatment in such tooth. So now in this scenario, like you have to consider in a closed apex. Now we know in a root canal treatment, we have the obturation which we are doing. In the obturation, we are going to fill the canal with the obturating material, that is your gutta percha. So now for example, now you consider if it is a closed apex. So now when you're inserting your gutta percha into the canal, so you'll see that there's a stop and your gutta percha, it will go and it will stop over here, because now over here, this is an closed apex, and because of this, you have that stop, so that your gutta percha, when you're inserting it into the canal, it will have this stop. But now for example, if the canal or if the apex is open, so now in this, if you want to do the root canal treatment, so you're doing the root canal treatment and now you're doing the obturation. So now as there is an open apex, so now your gutta percha, it will go into the periapical space. Because now in this, the apex, it is open and there's no stop, so that where your gutta percha, it will go and stop. And in such cases, you need this apexification in which you're going to make or you're going to form or create this apex. So now in this, what you're going to do is in this apexification, you basically fill this canal with some material so that a barrier is formed over here. Though you're not forming the apex, you're just doing the formation of a calcific barrier. So now as a definition, it is the method to induce. It is the method to form a calcific barrier across an open apex. So you're forming a calcific barrier with the help of material. That is the most commonly used material are your calcium hydroxide and MTA. So these are the basic two materials that you're using for the apexification, in which with the help of this two material, any of this two material, you're going to form a barrier. So now that you have formed your barrier, that is your calcific barrier, with the help of these, any of this two material. So now you're going to do the root canal treatment and you're doing the obturation. Now there's a barrier which has formed due to this apexification. Now when you're inserting your GP, now as there's a stop and a barrier, your GP, it won't go in the periapical space. So this is basically what your apexification means, that you're inducing a calcific barrier across an open apex of a immature. So in this case, now if the apex is open, so obviously your tooth is immature and it is a pulpless, because now you want to do the root canal treatment. So you have done your root canal treatment and then only you can do the apexification. So your tooth, it is a pulpless tooth. So this is the definition for your apexification. Now what is the indication? So it is indicated for the non-vital permanent teeth with the open apex, and that open apex tooth is known as a blunderbuss canal. So this is the basic indication for your apexification. Now what is the objective of doing this apexification? So basically there are two objectives of doing apexification. So one of this objective can be you are creating this calcific barrier. So first is your calcific barrier creation. And one more like objective can be you can close the open apical third of the root canal. So you're just closing the root canal, like apical third of your root canal, with the help of this apexification. So these are the two basic objectives of apexification. Now what is the rationale of doing this apexification? So now in this, what you'll see is in this, the actual root growth, it won't occur, but there's just a calcified barrier which has formed. In this, your root is not forming. In this, the barrier is forming. So you have to like remember about this apexification. Now there's one more term that is known as apexogenesis. So now you don't confuse yourself between these two words. Now genesis is nothing but you are forming the apex. So in apexogenesis, you are forming the root, but in apexification, you are forming a calcific barrier
or you're helping this apex to close. So that is the difference between your apexogenesis and apexification. So now if your apexification is successful, so you have done your apexification properly, so you'll see that a hard substance which is histologically described as, so you can describe this material, that is your like barrier, as it can be described as dentin, or it can be described as bone or osteodentin or cementum. So this is the material which has formed in the apex, and because of this you can do now your obturation properly. So now in this, there were several materials which were used for this apexification, like the collagen calcium phosphate gel, or there was a material which was known as tricalcium phosphate. So these were like the various material which were tried for the apexification, but the most commonly used ones are your calcium hydroxide and the mineral trioxide aggregate. So these are the two material that we are commonly using. So now in this, you have two methods of doing this apexification. One can be in multiple step and one can be in single step. So you are in this multiple step, you're calling or you're recalling the patient again and again. But in single step, in this, you're doing the apexification at once. So now this multi-step, it is done with the help of calcium hydroxide, and single step, it is done with the help of mineral trioxide aggregates. So now in this, the calcium hydroxide is the most common and traditional material which is used for the apexification, but the technique, it is typically a multi-visit like approach, and it takes around 6 months to 4 years to complete. So this is a multiple like step, and it takes around 6 months to 4 years to complete this apexification. So now we are going to see the basic procedure. So first, what you're doing is, now you have done the complete like diagnosis, you have seen the radiograph that the apex is open, and you want to do the apexification. So first you're going to anesthetize the tooth, then you're going to isolate the tooth with the help of a rubber dam, and you're going to start with your access opening, that is your root canal treatment. And after that, what you're going to do is you're going to determine your working length. Now we know the various methods of determining the working length, and the most commonly used ones are the radiographic and the electronic apex locator. So with the help of them, you're going to determine the working length, and you have to see that whenever you are seeing the working length, so in case of apexification, you're going to keep the working length 2 mm short of your radiographic apex. Now you know your apex, so you have anatomic apex and you have radiographic apex. So now when you're like seeing the working length, you are seeing the radiographic apex on a radiograph. So in that case, what you're going to do is you're going to keep the working length 2 mm short, and then you're going to start with the circumferential enlargement in the like lateral pressure against the walls with a large files. So now you have inserted your like 10 number K file for your working length, and after that you're going to start with the like enlargement of your canal. So your, if your canal is very narrow, so with the help of files, you're going to enlarge this canal, so that when you want to insert your material, that is your calcium hydroxide, the canal is wide enough. So because of that, you're going to do the circumferential enlargement of the canal with the help of a large file. Then you're going to dry the canal properly with the help of your paper point. So you're just going to insert the paper point in the canal, and you're going to dry the canal properly. And then what you're going to do is you're going to mix your calcium hydroxide with sterile water or the anesthetic solution to a thick consistency. Then you are mixing your calcium hydroxide, and then you are going to deliver this paste. So now you have like mixed your calcium hydroxide. Now you are going to carry this calcium hydroxide with the help of a amalgam carrier, and then you are going to like insert this calcium hydroxide into the canal, and then you are going to condense that calcium hydroxide with the help of a plugger. Now in this, now what you're going to do is you're going to fill the entire root canal with calcium hydroxide, and you have to see that your calcium hydroxide, it is touching the periapical space properly, so that if there's a periapical lesion which is present, so your calcium hydroxide, it will help in the reduction of that periapical lesion also. And then you're going to seal it with the resin modified GIC. So you have filled all of the canal with the calcium hydroxide, and then you're going to seal the opening and everything with the GIC, and then the patient, they are recalled after 3 months. So now when the patient, they come after 3 months, so there are two scenarios, that the calcium, like you have seen a calcific barrier or you have not seen the calcific barrier. So now if you see radiographically the calcific barrier, it has formed, so you will do the obturation. But now if you see there's no calcific barrier radiographically, then again what you're going to do is you're just going to change your calcium hydroxide dressing, and then again you're going to recall the patient every 3 months till that barrier is seen properly. And once the barrier is seen, then you're going to complete the obturation. So this is the basic procedure for your multiple step apexification with the help of calcium hydroxide. So it is multiple step because you're recalling the patient in this like period of months. So this is the first like method of apexification. Now the next method is a single step apexification with the help of a mineral trioxide aggregate. So now in this, the first, second and third, fourth, like the first, second, third, fourth step, they remain the same. Now in this, you were mixing the calcium hydroxide because it was the technique with the help of a calcium hydroxide. But now in this, you're going to mix the mineral trioxide aggregate in the ratio of 3:1, again using the sterile distilled water to a wet sand consistency. And then you're going to deliver the paste into the canal with the help of a MTA carrier, and then you're going to condense it with the plugger. So this is the same procedure. Like in this, you're mixing calcium hydroxide. Over here, you're mixing the MTA and you're going to like condense it into the canal. But now over here, the difference is, now in calcium hydroxide, whole of the canal, it was filled with calcium hydroxide. But now in this MTA, what you're going to do is you're just going to fill MTA in 3 to 4 mm apical plug. So you're just like filling this MTA in the 3 to 4 mm apical region. And then what you're going to do is you're going to place a cotton pellet, moist cotton pellet over the MTA. And then you're going to call or recall the patient after 48 hours to see that your MTA, it has set properly. And then what you're going to do is, as you have seen, so you're going to remove your cotton pellet and then you're going to see that your MTA is properly set. And then finally, you're going to do the obturation. So now in this, now you can see you're not recalling the patient like in this calcium hydroxide after 3 months or 6 months. But in this, you're going to do the like apexification in a single step itself. It's just that you're going to call the patient after 2 days just to see that your MTA, it is set properly or not. And if your MTA, it is set properly, and then you're going to do your obturation. So these are the two methods, like various methods of doing the apexification. Now there's an extra point for your single step like MTA apexification. So in this, you'll see that the tissue pH, it may affect the hydration reaction and the final physical property or MTA. So because of that, it is advised that you're going to like insert calcium hydroxide in the canal for at least 1 week, and then you're going to start with your like apexification with the help of the MTA. So this is the basic step. If you don't want any complication further, so just that you can do that, you are inserting the calcium hydroxide into the canal for 1 week, and then you're going to start with your MTA apexification. So this is about the MTA apexification. Now what are the outcomes that you'll see on the radiograph after you have done the apexification? So like there can be any of these four outcomes. So you'll see that the calcification barrier, it has formed at the apex, or you can see that the calcific barrier, it is formed coronal to the apex somewhere over here, or there can be root growth and the apical calcification also, but this is very rare. Most of the thing you'll see is a calcific barrier that has formed, or there will be a dystrophic calcification which is seen in this canal. So these are like the outcome of your apexification which you'll see on the radiograph. So this is about the apexification. So over here, now I'm going to show you the clinical picture of the apexification, like how it looks radiographically. So now in this first picture, now you can see over here, this is your central incisor and this is an open apex. Now you can consider the difference between these two. So over here, now you can see the apex, it is closed. Over here, the apex is like opened and the canal, they are so wide. Over here, there's also a periapical lesion which you can see. So now you're going to start with your apexification. So this is nothing but your clamps of your rubber dam. This is the second step that you're like determining the working length. So now you can see over here, the working length, it is kept 2 mm short of your radiographic apex. So this will be your radiographic apex, and this is where you're going to keep your working length as. So now you have seen the working length and you have removed all the debris, and after that you're going to fill the canal with the help of this calcium hydroxide. So now this is the calcium hydroxide which you have filled, and over here you're placing the GIC as we have seen in the like procedure. Now over here you can see that the calcium hydroxide, it is getting resorbed, but the calcific barrier, it is not formed yet. So what you're going to do is, again you're going to insert the like calcium hydroxide into the canal after 3 months, and then you're going to see a like calcific barrier which has formed over here, and after that you're going to like insert your GP and you're going to complete your obturation. Now again in this, now you can see over here, this is an open apex. Now you can see over here the canals, they are so wide when you're comparing it with the another tooth. So now over here you can see the apex is closed and the canals, they are so narrow. So this is an open apex. So now what you're doing is you're going to like insert the material again as the same which you have seen, and now you're going to recall the patient. So now you can see over here, this is how your calcific barrier it looks like. So this is the white portion. So this is the calcific barrier which has formed, and this is the picture microscopically. So you'll see that this barrier, so this white thing over here into the canal is nothing but your like calcific barrier which has formed with the help of a calcium hydroxide. So this is the obturation that you're doing, and this is how it looks like microscopically, and this is the radiographic picture after you have done the obturation. So now in this, the obturation that you're doing is the thermoplasticized obturation, that is the obturation which is like through the thermoplasticized technique. So this was all about the apexification. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, then please like, comment, share and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.